George Zimmerman has been found not guilty, but that doesn't mean Trayvon Martin's death was unavoidable. The trial jury apparently relied on ambiguity surrounding the events in Florida to acquit Zimmerman, but the neighborhood watchman's decision still led to the confrontation itself. Now, Huffington Post's Ryan Grimm has identified six alternative decisions George Zimmerman could have made that would have changed Martin's fate. And here to discuss those with us is Zach Carter, our HuffPost senior political economy reporter. Zach, let's go through some of these options. The first one, perhaps the most obvious, Zimmerman could have not decided to follow Martin. The second, he could have listened to the 911 operator and not followed Martin. Three, he could have been, it says, if Zimmerman had not been secretly armed, he probably wouldn't have followed Martin. So it's all about really following Martin. The last two, if Zimmerman's weapon had not been hidden, Martin probably would have dealt with him differently, and Zimmerman could have barred from carrying a weapon. So kind of talking through a lot of the same points, whether he would have had the weapon on him, whether he should or would have not chased Zimmerman, Trayvon Martin. What do you make of these options, Zach?
I think it becomes very, very clear that whatever happened in the scuffle between Trayvon Martin and George Zimmerman is largely immaterial to whether or not George Zimmerman could have taken actions that would have enabled Trayvon Martin to continue living before that scuffle ensued. I think Ryan's story is really great. You know, even if you put the gun issues to the side, I mean, George Zimmerman makes several decisions. One, to care, to be out there in the first place, to be looking for somebody suspicious, to decide that Trayvon Martin is suspicious, to get out of the car after the 911 operator says don't get out of the car. I mean, those are all decisions that he makes that initiates this chain of events in which he is reacting once he set off this chain of events. And then I think the gun stuff is really interesting because even independently of the stand your ground laws,
right?
I mean, he has a concealed weapon. If you have a weapon that's out there where people, if you see someone approaching you with a gun and a holster giving you a hard time, you're going to run away from that guy. But the fact that he had a concealed weapon allowed this conflict to escalate in ways that it wouldn't have otherwise. And so, I think the gun laws are really a peripheral issue here. This is mostly an issue of racial justice in my mind. This is racial profiling and literally the case of someone hunting down a black kid for no reason. I mean, that seems to be the overriding issue here. But it is true that with better gun laws in the United States, that the result of this conflict would maybe not have been fatal.